We have with us Gautam Sharma, MD Inmarsat India. Gautam, would you talk about India operations and the activities that you are doing?
Inmarsat has been in India for almost 35 years. We've been giving our services to various defense organizations, including Army, Air Force, as well as to disaster agencies. In 2014, we have signed an agreement with BSNL for giving services, and also by setting up a gateway, a world-class GSPS gateway in BSNL, which is located in Ghaziabad. So initially we've started giving our GSPS, that is voice services, satellite phone services, along with SMS and 2.4 kbps data services. Initially these, in phase one, these services are being given to all the government organizations, and later on they will be given to general public, whoever needs to utilize communications on the move. And moving forward, we also have a plan to enhance the data capabilities from 2.4 kbps to 492 kbps. That's a plan which we have. Currently, we are serving Navy, Air Force, Army, and all these organizations.
Gautam, would you talk about in-flight connectivity services that you are providing to airlines industry in the country as well as globally?
Inmarsat aviation business is growing leap and bounds, especially because of the MH370 incident. We are providing in-flight connectivity to passengers, as well as we're also giving safety services in the cockpit. We've signed various agreements with Lufthansa, Singapore Airlines, and many other airlines, and we're already giving services, in-flight connectivity to these global airlines. We believe there is a huge potential in India when it comes to in-flight connectivity. Actually, in in-flight connectivity, when it comes to India, there are two things which we are looking into. One is the overflight. These are the flights which don't land in India. And the second one is the flights which land in India. The overflight, we believe, should be kind of, we should allow all these aeroplanes who already have terminals deployed in these airplanes to utilize these services. And when it comes to the domestic airlines, we just believe that it should be kind of technology neutral. It should be the airlines who should decide whether they want to go for KU capabilities or who wants to go for KA bandwidth.
With the number of equipments that you are servicing in India increasing, what's your aftermarket strategy for the services part of these equipment?
Usually, as I mentioned earlier, we sell through partners. Most of our partners are with us from last 30-35 years, and they have very good engineers as well as service centers. And they are capable of taking care of after-sales service. And moving forward, if required, we will be also setting up some service centers in India.
On India Mobile Congress?
I think India Mobile Congress is a big success. We really appreciate the efforts of DOT, COI, and all the stakeholders. I think yesterday was amazing. All the leaders were here, and everybody is talking about convergence, and convergence is here to stay. So I believe it was a very successful event.